This video is brought to you by Answerly, a question platform that pays you for adding high-quality answers on different questions. The users are rewarded in Answerly tokens, which they can easily convert into dollars or any other cryptocurrency by using one of the exchanges mentioned in the description.
As you take on the role of Agent 47, its deadly abilities, tools, and instincts are at your fingertips.
With games like Hitman and Metal Gear Solid 5 being released, some of us are just itching to give games of the same genre a try. Here are some of the most insane stealth games for you that will not lose out to its predecessors. Hello and welcome back to our YouTube channel. In today's video, we will check out the top 5 insane stealth games for low-end PCs. If you're new here, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell to get updates whenever we post. Without further ado, let's get started. Metal Gear Solid 1. Metal Gear Solid 1 requirements: memory 2 GB, graphics card Intel HD family, CPU Intel Pentium 3258, file size 1 GB, OS Windows 7. While the latest Metal Gear Solid 5 is too far out of reach for some, the first title of the franchise can hold its ground against it. Metal Gear Solid 1 was one of gaming's most well-known franchises, and the first game on the PS1 was what catapulted Hideo Kojima into the annals of gaming history. Back in the late 80s and 90s, no one had ever seen anything quite like these games. They were cinematic, had a complex narrative, and some of the best stealth gameplay that was available at the time. Because Metal Gear is broken down into such bite-sized chunks, it makes it easy to manage. You have access to the transmission system that allows you to be updated by your commander, and then the game becomes a stealth puzzle game. You need to figure out how to best proceed, and in a lot of cases that requires careful observation of your enemies. The stealth aspect is also easy to manage even with a radar. Every enemy or camera that has a direct line of sight, if you stand in front of them without something in the way, then they will see you. It's very simple and makes sneaking past enemies fun and fluid once you get the hang of it, especially once the cardboard box makes an appearance. Whether it's from the 80s, 90s, or 2000s, it seems like every game in the Metal Gear Solid series holds its own in the modern era. The older games have some clunk here or there, but there's something just innately compelling about the gameplay that stops it from feeling stale. Aragami. Aragami system requirements: CPU speed 2.6 GHz single core, RAM 1 GB, OS Windows XP SP2, video card DirectX 9.0C compatible graphics card at least 256 MB, Pixel Shader 3.0, Vertex Shader 3.0, sound card yes, free disk space 3 GB, dedicated video RAM at least 256 MB. Aragami is a third-person stealth game which casts you as an undead assassin with the power to control the shadows. Teleport to any shadow, become invisible, materialize weapons, or even summon a shadow dragon to infiltrate the enemy ranks and dispose of your targets. Aragami's case is presented with unexpected care and tickles the player's curiosity as it uses the old and successful trick of flashbacks and notification of scattered plot elements per chapter in order to maintain interest as high as possible. The hero of the adventure is a guy named Aragami, an undead warrior invoked by Yamiko, a desperate princess who claims to be imprisoned by the Kaiho, the Warriors of Light. As a silent assassin, Aragami's power comes from the shadows, where when he is there, he is almost one of them. He is invisible to the naked human eye, unless one comes too close, and has a number of other manipulative abilities that make him a true shadow dancer. His main abilities are those of teleportation between the shadows, always within a reasonable distance, as well as the creation of a temporary shadow hearth, which allows him to then move there even when the space around him is bright enough. The Dark Mod. The Dark Mod system requirements: OS, Windows, Mac uses a Winfront, Linux, processor, Pentium 4 1.5 GHz or Athlon XP 1500 Plus processor or higher, memory 384 MB of RAM, graphics 100% DirectX 9.0B compatible 64 MB hardware, accelerated video card and the latest drivers, hard drive space 2.5 GB of free space. The Dark Mod isn't a standalone game. It's not even really a mod either. TDM is more like a TC, a total conversion for Doom 3, and it's one inspired by the classic Thief titles from the late 90s and early 2000s. It was actually after Thief Deadly Shadows came out in 2004 that the team behind it got together and decided they could do better. Several of the team members who spent 5 years working on the excellent unofficial expansion for Thief 2, The Metal Age, T2X were recruited to help work on this project. The AI in this game is supposed to be on par with and even better than the OG's original games. If you've watched all the trailers or even played the game, you'll see that they are capable of a few tricks. They can do the regular stuff, such as patrol, lie down or stand still, or mutter to themselves, more on this later, but NPCs can also sit down at a table, eat food, play cards with each other, and instead of doors magically opening by themselves, characters actually reach out to open and close them. The Dark Mod is a mod that has incredible longevity and replayability, catering to those who want to make things harder in missions by changing difficulty modes and tweaking things in the options menu so there's less HUD and other things that give you an unfair advantage. Mark of the Ninja. System requirements: OS Windows XP SP3, Windows Vista SP2, Windows 7 SP1. Processor: AMD Phenom 9750 or Pentium D800+. Memory: 2 GB of RAM. Graphics: NVIDIA GeForce 7800 GT or ATI Radeon HD 3000+ or better. DirectX 9.0C. Hard drive: 2.5 GB of hard drive space. Sound: 100% DirectX 9.0C compatible sound card and drivers. In a move that's simultaneously refreshing and familiar, Mark of the Ninja is a 2D stealth adventure that, at first glance, looks a bit Metroidvania-esque. You'll jump and grapple hook your way around mostly linear levels, though occasional path choices and backtracking occur, clinging to walls and ceilings, hiding in floor grates, and pressing B to duck behind potted plants or in doorways, all in the name of avoiding detection. You begin with only these two most basic moves, but as you finish levels and secondary objectives within each mission, such as completing an area without raising an alarm, you'll earn medals redeemable for new moves that significantly liven up the game and open up your options. More seriously laudable is Ninja's scoring system. While many stealth games claim you can play them how you want, read lethally or non-lethally, this one actually rewards you with medal earning XP either way. If you knife every fool, you earn some points. Hide their bodies when you're done and you'll net more. Terrorize them and you'll bag yet more or score plenty of points just for sneaking by the bad guys undetected. This is complemented by additional play styles that become available as you go, like Way of the Ninja. This removes your sword, thereby making it nearly impossible to kill anyone, but gives you extra distraction tools such as the aforementioned cardboard box, firecrackers, terror darts, etc. It wholly changes the way the game is played, akin to watching a different director's cut of your favorite movie. And lastly, to out top one, Thief 2. System requirements: OS Windows XP or Windows Vista. Processor: 1.8 GHz processor. Memory: 512 MB RAM, 1 GB recommended. Hard disk space: 2 GB of hard drive space. Video card: 3D graphics card compatible with DirectX 7, compatible with DirectX 9 recommended. DirectX 7. A big part of Thief's strength comes in the storyline, which is dark, completely original, and absolutely enthralling. Since this is a sequel, a lot of the initial thrill of seeing the past and forward environments in the Metal Age is gone, but in its place is a solid sense of security and momentum. Looking Glass has gotten comfortable with both the gameplay and the storyline with the sequel, and it shows. The game plays even smarter and slower in case you're wondering, and they've gone to great lengths to include tons of details and crucial story points within the levels themselves, elaborating on the strengths of the original game. The cutscenes are just as stylistically pleasing and watchable as the original, with the same great art style and even more heady exposition from the Keepers and Garrett that never turns schlocky. The graphics are baby step better than the first, but unfortunately, the Dark Engine is still the big wart on an otherwise near-perfect game. Well, there you have it, the top 5 insane stealth games for low-end PCs that will turn you into a silent assassin. And that's it for today's video, guys. Let us know what you think about this list in the comments section below.
If you like this video, make sure to smash the like button and subscribe to this channel. To learn more about Answerly and Answerly tokens, check out the links in the description.